They make a million of these Fast and Furious movies. Listen, if you like them, more power to you. I stopped watching them a long time ago. It seems like now they're giving them spin-offs, all kinds of stuff. So this is like a huge movie franchise. I stopped watching them, like I said, after like the third one. And I don't think I'm ever going to go back because they have little to do with street racing and more with busting up crazy kingpins and stuff. Like I'm not interested. But Gina Carano is a part of this franchise. She played Riley Hicks in Fast and the Furious 6, or just Fast and Furious. Okay. I don't know anything about the movie. I never watched it. The third one was where I stopped. But she is a part of the franchise. She played a villain, and she was apparently killed in the movie. So I don't know how she would manage to come back, but apparently the franchise has done this before. Han, the guy from the third one, I guess, has come back to life somehow, and he seemed pretty dead in that movie, but he's back, apparently. So it's being reported from SB Nation Bloody Elbow, mostly an MMA site, that Gina Carano was reportedly fired by Fast and Furious franchise for fear of PR headaches. So apparently, here's what was going to happen. Her character was going to be brought back to life through movie magic and was going to return to the franchise in some fashion. I don't know if they would turn her into a hero or if she was going to come back as a villain again. I'm not sure. And I'm also not sure how much I believe this rumor, considering it comes from We Got This Covered and Daniel Reichman again, or Richman, or however you say his last name, because he's kind of inconsistent too. Sometimes he gets things right, sometimes he doesn't, but a lot of these websites, not just We Got This Covered, will run with things he says, and sometimes they're a little ridiculous. He's saying, without presenting any evidence, that Universal's executives feared Carano could potentially cause them PR headaches based on her personal and political opinions. This website points out that Carano does not have a long history of controversial posts or statements. 2020 is thought to be the first year Carano began sharing views that were met with immediate backlash. So that's the rumor going around with this. I don't know. I think it's possible that they were thinking about bringing her back for Fast and Furious, because if you think about it, her star power was and is still pretty big. So if you already have her as a character in the series, why not bring her back? And I'm sure, you know, she would have done it because, well, it's a huge franchise and it probably would have brought a big paycheck. So it's not crazy to think that they were going to bring her back. However, the sources here just aren't that good. But I do think it's something that could have potentially been true. Her character was lampooned in the sixth one, apparently, according to Fast and Furious Villains Wiki. But like I also said, that Han character, from what I understand, I don't remember how he died. I think he died in an explosion or a fire or something. And then the dude walks into Brooms eating crackers in a trailer for that movie. I did see that. So, you know, anything's possible in movies. I'm just not sure on this one. I don't think this one is true. But then again, you never know. But it wouldn't shock me if maybe it was a discussion had and then they shot it down because, well, you know, we don't want the 45 people on Twitter to get upset now and come after our franchise. So anyway, tell me what you guys think in the comments below. Do you think they were going to bring her back? Do you think that this is nothing? I'd like to hear what you have to say. Do you like these movies also? Like, I'm so shocked that this has managed to have, like, I guess if you count the spinoffs, I don't even know how many there are. With a ninth one coming, that means there's like, what, 12 or 13 of these movies? It's so ridiculous to me. Are these movies that great that they need so many spinoffs? Let me know if you like these. Also, if you would please like, subscribe, share the video. Make sure you're still subscribed. Hit that notification bell. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace. Also, if you want to help support the channel, check out my Teespring store. There's a link in the description. You can find some merchandise in there that you might want to check out.